So what I'm going to do, I'm going to give you an overview of sustainable water management in the changing climate and how it is linked also to the European Green Deal. And let me start firstly by saying that water is a cross-cutting issue that connects all living beings, and economic development is inseparably linked to the availability of good quality water. And of course, water plays a very central role in the context of climate change. Why? Firstly, because our fresh waters, our oceans and seas, are heavily affected by climate change. We are noticing increased floods and droughts and storms, and they are taking a harsh toll on our economy and human life. Ocean warming, sea level rise, and acidification are all ongoing, and they are very hard to adapt to. Secondly, because there is no way we can solve the climate crisis without stepping up efforts to secure cleaner and better managed fresh waters and seas. So protecting our nature and securing sustainable growth is one and the same goal for us. What is good is that, in fact, we have quite a lot of solutions already in place. And some of the speakers mentioned that the Water Framework Directive is already in place. And if we steer all our efforts to step up the implementation of the Water Framework Directive, the Floods Directive, the Groundwater Directive, and all the other relevant pieces of legislation, I think that we can say with confidence that we have largely the policies we need to manage flood risks, droughts, and safeguard water ecosystems and ensure we have a sufficient amount of high quality water. We have these policies in place. Despite the fact that the Water Framework Directive does not explicitly refer to climate change, all the elements that are important to address climate change are there. So for instance, the definition of water status, which allows to cater for climate change impacts. Then we have the cyclical approach in place where member states have to prepare river basin management plans regularly. So that means that they have the opportunity to constantly reassess the actual status of their freshwater bodies and take the most effective actions to preserve them. The Floods Directive explicitly requires member states to factor climate change in their flood risk management plans. So when we have the legislation in place and we believe that the elements to address climate change are there, are we satisfied with what is happening, and can we say that our water management is going in the right direction? Well, let us look at the state of the EU waters based on the 2018 European Environment Agency report on the current state of EU waters. And here you can see that for surface waters, only 40% of surface waters have good or high ecological status, and 38% of them have good chemical status. In relation to the groundwater bodies, 89% have good quantitative status and 74% of them have good chemical status. The Commission's implementation report, which assessed the second river basin management plans and the first flood risk management plans and was published in February last year, assessed how the member states implemented the Water Framework Directive. And in relation to the issue of water scarcity and climate change, we conducted a quite detailed analysis for each country. And here you can find some of the issues that were highlighted for the member states. So in relation to water scarcity, droughts, we concluded that in about half of the member states, drought management plans were not prepared where they were supposed to be prepared. And we defined also recommendations for preparing the third river basin management plan. So here you can see some of the recommendations as examples. So for instance, we highlighted that there is a need to better define and implement environmental flow. Then abstraction controls should be in place and information on uses, water exploitation and trends to be collected and reported. And indeed, we recommended to prepare drought management plans where appropriate. For the flood risk management plans, over half of the member states considered climate change at the preliminary flood risk assessments and flood hazard and risk map steps. And the recommendation is to improve factoring in climate change in the next flood risk management plans. In 2019, you are probably familiar with that, we carefully analyzed the existing EU legislation on water, whether it is still fit for the purpose, and whether there is a need to change anything in order to make the legislation more responsive to future challenges. The conclusion of the fitness check was that the Water Framework Directive and its daughter directives and the Floods Directive are largely fit for purpose with some room for improvement. In fact, it was mentioned in the fitness check that the reason that some of the objectives of the water legislation were not achieved are not due to deficiencies in the legislation, but mainly due to insufficient funding, slow implementation, and insufficient mainstreaming of environmental objectives in sectoral policies. So here I have to agree with the previous speaker who mentioned if the Water Framework Directive, the Floods Directive and all the other pieces of legislation are fully implemented by all member states, then I think we don't have problems with different issues and also the one that we are discussing today. As for future challenges, the fitness check concluded that the Water Framework Directive is fit for purpose and is flexible enough to address the future challenges such as climate change and water scarcity. So there is no need to change it.
Dagmar,
for the, sorry?
2 minutes.
For the Floods Directive, for the implementation, the knowledge and modeling of the impact of climate change on all sources of floods should be improved. So now I come to the European Green Deal. This is the Commission's strategy, how to factor in climate change and environmental challenges while ensuring the economic growth. It is an opportunity to bring about a circular economy, and there are many actions where water features prominently. So here you can see the list of different initiatives under the European Green Deal. And in each of them, you can find water reflected and some measures addressing either protecting of ecosystems or water efficiency or mainstreaming of water objectives in other sectoral policies. Let me focus now in particular on the biodiversity strategy, which I think is the most relevant for our today's webinar. So the biodiversity strategy was adopted in May this year, and its main focus, or it focuses on main drivers of biodiversity loss. And there are some key targets of relevance for water policy, in particular on river restoration and marine and nature protected areas. On this slide, you can see those main objectives that are relevant for water. So I would like to highlight restoration of freshwater ecosystems, where the biodiversity strategy identifies that increased efforts are needed to restore freshwater ecosystems and the natural functions of rivers. There is a target to restore at least 25,000 kilometers free-flowing rivers. How to achieve that? By removing of obsolete barriers and by restoring of floodplains and wetlands. And there is a need to restore and preserve ecological flows. So member states need to review water abstraction and impoundment permits. And this is directly relevant for the Water Framework Directive objectives to be met by 2027. All in all, the focus is to implement and enforce EU environmental legislation. From the forthcoming initiatives, I have to highlight the new EU strategy for adaptation to climate change, which is foreseen for adoption in the first quarter of next year. And it's currently being finalized in the Commission. And indeed, water will feature prominently in this new EU adaptation strategy. The focus will be mainly on availability of fresh water, on the use of nature-based solutions as multi-beneficial tools to address problems with droughts and floods, resilience in cities, the use of green infrastructure, then looking for adaptation solutions through research, and mainly we will be using Horizon Europe research, and then focusing on collaboration between all levels of governance, plus transboundary cooperation will be introduced in the new EU adaptation strategy. I am slowly getting to the end, so let me now say a few words about the next steps that are in front of us. So indeed, we are going to follow up the assessment of the second river basin management plans and the first flood risk management plans and the fitness check. In particular, I would like to highlight here that the Commission will work together with the member states to improve the implementation of both directives. And we will work also with the member states on some guidance documents or supporting them in implementing river continuity and e-flows as part of the common implementation strategy, which is a platform for cooperating between the Commission and the member states and stakeholders. Also, in relation to the biodiversity strategy, the Commission is going to prepare guidance or technical support to member states on how to achieve the target of 25,000 kilometers of free-flowing rivers. That should be done by 2021. And also to support member states on e-flows. As I mentioned already, the new EU adaptation strategy and follow-up will be in 2021. And finally, we are hoping that the member states will follow up on the issues that were highlighted in the latest Commission report on the implementation of the Water Framework Directive and the Floods Directive, and they will reflect them in the new river basin management plans and second flood risk management plans, which are due by the end of next year. And we will be looking carefully into the assessment and into the measures introduced in those plans. So here I would stop, and I am happy to respond to any questions. Thank you.